Coping with deer in a garden can be a real problem. It seems like those of us who live in suburban areas, the deer population is increasing, there really aren't any effective controls, and they are simply driven by hunger, particularly when the population explodes. Now, over the years, I've tried all sorts of things. Some of them, I have to confess, are downright wacky and frankly just don't work. But there are some other ones that do and might be worth your while considering if you've got a deer problem in your garden. The first thing is told to me by a friend of mine, and he says it works pretty good, and that is to use talcum powder. Now, all you do is you take the talcum powder and sprinkle it over the tops of your plants. He says that there's something about the texture, the smell, or maybe the taste of talcum powder that deer don't like. But I have to say, I'm not too sure that I want to have my plants all covered with talcum powder. Now, there's also various repellents that you can buy at the garden centers, and some of these are really very good. The trouble is that you have to replenish them frequently. That is, that you have to spray your plants frequently, especially after rain. Now, an adaption of that is to use garden twine that's been soaked in repellent. You can soak it and then stretch it around your areas of plants, and that makes it go further. And one of the things that's worked really very good for me over the years is to use fishing line. There's something about the almost invisible nature of fishing line that deer don't want to get tangled up in it. And all I do is I use some stakes like these, stick them into the ground, and then stretch a single layer of fishing line around the area, and they normally don't bother that too much. But if you employ this, there's something that I really want to warn you about. Be careful, because if it ever gets broken and runs about in the garden, you know, there might be other animals or perhaps birds that will get tangled up in the fishing line. So I'm not sure that that's really something that I would totally recommend. Now, of course, the most effective and probably the most permanent is, of course, to build a fence around your garden. But if you do that, the fence needs to be at least 8 foot tall. Believe it or not, that's the height that a deer can jump. I'm not sure that I really want to live in a deer-fenced area that's expensive, and so what I do is I tend to mix up and use a variety of solutions. And the important thing is to keep ringing the changes. Don't rely on any single method. Use a variety of them. Here's a couple more for you. Now, one of the things I've done is to use these dryer strips. Now, they work really very good. They have this strong smell, and all I do is I take them and pin them onto the plants at about the height of a deer nose. I also use bars of soap. I try to find the strongest fragrant ones I can. I drill right through the wrapper, drill a hole right through wrapper, bar of soap and all, and then with an electrical tie, I put them again at about the height of a deer's nose, and that will work really very good for a long time. As I say, it's important to ring the changes and don't rely on any one single method. Now, another approach is to grow plants that deer normally don't bother to browse on. Things like this boxwood here that I have growing up in my woodland garden. There are lots of other plants too. Take, for instance, the Japanese silvergrass, Miscanthus, and many of the other ornamental grasses they don't bother with. Then there's things like Russian sage and a whole host of plants that we list on our website, gardensplendor.com, as plants that are not preferred by deer. I'm not really sure that there's anything that's totally deer resistant, because when you have a hungry deer in the middle of the winter, if it thought it was going to get some nutrient from a barbed wire fence, it would nearly have a go at that. So you see that there's a variety of things that you can do to cope with deer in your garden. But of all the things I've tried over the years, I think the most successful has been this. This is Morgan. She's my full-time garden companion and part-time deer deterrent, because she comes out with me, stays with me here in the garden, and as she's moving around, she's depositing scents, which of course, as the deer come along, they sense as a predator. So Morgan helps me keep my garden free of troublesome deer problems. This is David Wilson for Garden Splendor with another simple, easy little suggestion that I hope will help you become more successful with your gardening.
Good girl. Good girl.
Garden splendor, the plants worth remembering.